Hey everybody, John with Freshwater Systems. We get some questions from time to time, and we got a couple of questions recently that I thought we should address. One of our customers wrote to us. He'd had a water treatment salesman in his house looking over some concerns that he had, and he had bought a filter from us. The salesman pulled out his little TDS meter and challenged his carbon filter and told him the carbon filter wasn't working because the TDS read exactly the same as what was coming out of his tap. So his question to us was, how is this possible? Plus, I thought this was a half micron carbon filter. Well, in the beginning of my answer to him, I told him that he was comparing two measurements to try and come to the same conclusion. First of all, let's talk about the TDS meter that he used to test the water. TDS stands for total dissolved solids. And these are inorganic minerals that are in solution. They're not solid. They're dissolved. Best analogy I can use with that is take an Alka-Seltzer tablet and drop it in a glass of water. That 3,000 milligram tablet will bubble up and it turns all kinds of bubbles into the water glass, and eventually it's clear. That water glass, you can't see any of that Alka-Seltzer tablet left. That was a solid dissolving into a total dissolved solid. So if that kind of helps you understand what a dissolved solid is. Well, TDS is a measurement of those dissolved solids, and it does that through conductivity. And the salesman had one of these types of TDS meters. And he put this in the water that came out of the filter, and it puts a little bit of an electric current between the two probes on the bottom of the meter. It's testing for how conductive the water is. The higher the level of dissolved solids in the water, the higher the level is going to read on the TDS meter. Well, the carbon filter that he has under his sink, it doesn't remove dissolved solids at all. So testing with a TDS meter is really not going to tell anything. Carbon, and this particular carbon, was a half micron, and it's rated for cyst reduction. Well, a lot of carbon filters come with a micron rating, and that is addressing strictly the porosity of the media, and it's going to stop any particulate that's larger than the porosity of the filter. The analogy I like to use with that is your screen door on the front door. You like to have that nice airflow through the screen, but you want to make sure that the flies don't come in with the air. So you have a mesh or a filter, if you will, on the front of your house. TDS would be when your neighbor's running his barbecue grill and you can smell what he's cooking, because that comes right through the screen door. So just like dissolved solids, that smell of the grill going on next door, those are not solids. They flow right through the screen. If you're interested or concerned about dissolved solids in your water, then you need to look for a reverse osmosis system which can reduce dissolved solids. And that TDS meter the salesman had, that's the tool that we use to test how well a reverse osmosis system is performing. So we take the TDS meter and we literally just put it in the water after we turn it on, and it gives us the levels. So in this little piece here, I have tap water, and our tap water is registering at 34.8. Now, we're in Greenville, South Carolina, and we're pretty blessed to have very low mineral content in our tap water. The water in the next smaller beaker is from a filtration device that we just fired up. It's a carbon filter, and it's registering at 30.7. So some of the dissolved solids actually came out of solution in that carbon filter. That usually doesn't happen, but we lost about 5 parts per million. Not a lot. This last small one is reverse osmosis water, and that's registering at less than 8. So you can see there is a difference between reverse osmosis and straight filter and the tap water. But as far as using one of these to measure how well your carbon filter's doing, it's not really going to tell you anything. The best way to understand whether or not your carbon filter is working, a lot of times, is with your taste buds and your nose. Carbon is going to be taking out things that cause taste and odor. In fact, most of the time when you buy a carbon filter, that's what you're buying it for, is to get rid of the chlorine taste and odor that you have on city water. And if you start to smell or taste that again, pretty good bet that the carbon filter is exhausted. Our best rule of thumb is it's more a matter of time, is to make sure you replace the filter adequately. Carbon filters do a great job. They've got lots of surface area for taste and odor issues. So if you let it go on and on and on, eventually it's going to be exhausted. The analogy I use with carbon filters is kind of like the parking structure down at the mall. When it's brand new or first thing in the morning, there's lots of parking spaces for those taste and odor organics to park. Once that lot is full, water flow can go through that carbon filter without slowing down much. So you don't see a pressure or flow loss like you would in a sediment filter that's clogged up. So just like Christmas time, you can drive all over the mall and not find an empty parking spot. You have to pull back on the road and go on. And that's what happens with the water. It flows through the carbon without slowing down. So the best case to kind of keep in mind is to replace that carbon filter no less than once a year. If you let it go more than a year, it's possible that it's really not doing any filtration for you, and you'll start to taste the chlorine again, and you'll start to get that smell in the water. So if you use a normal amount of water for a family of four, it's about a year for most carbons. If it's a little tiny one in a pitcher, that's going to be a lot more frequently, maybe once a month. If it's a fridge filter and you use a lot of water and a lot of ice, you probably should replace that maybe even every 6 months. But carbon needs to be replaced fairly frequently. So the bottom line is this. Depending upon what type of filtration system that you have, you need to test it for what it's supposed to do. So if you have a pH adjustment system because your water is slightly acidic, well then you want to test for pH. If you have a water softener to take hardness out of the water, obviously you want to test for hardness. So a reverse osmosis system, you want to test for dissolved solids. A carbon filter, you could test for chlorine breakthrough on a carbon on city water that's chlorinated. Now there is some carbon that has lead reduction capabilities that you can test for, and that's a great idea if you're concerned about lead in your house. So in closing, if you have any kind of question about your water, your filter system, and you're not really sure possibly of what the salesman told you, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to walk you through what to expect with the products that you have, or maybe even the products you're considering. We can certainly provide you some guidance on that. Well, that's all I've got for today. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check out all of our great filtration and testing products at freshwatersystems.com.